Tony Chiaverini of Kansas City.
Kansas City weighed this morning a natural 155.5 pounds. The underdog tonight facing his toughest test of his career in Wilfred Benitez, ex-welterweight champion, the smooth master boxer from Puerto Rico, who weighed a surprisingly heavy 155 pounds. Many wonder whether he can carry it. We will soon find out.
Wilfred Benitez against Kansas City's Tony Chiaverini, and we'll have the opening bell in just a moment. It's Wilfred Benitez, Tony Chiaverini, a good crowd in Las Vegas. Let's meet them now. Here's ring announcer Chuck Hull.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Caesars Palace Sports Pavilion, where tonight Top Rank Incorporated, in association with Caesars Palace, the site of the Holmes Ali Championship bout, presents the Friday night fights. These bouts are sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, Sig Rogich, chairman. The officials assigned by that commission, the judges are Art Lurie, Lou Tabbitt, and Dwayne Ford. The timekeeper is Jane Broadfoot. Counting at the knockdowns, Charlie Roth. The attending physician at ringside, Dr. Donald Romeo, and the referee for the main event, Ferd Hernandez. This is the feature attraction of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing in the junior middleweight division. Introducing, in the red corner, fighting out of Kansas City, weighing 155.5 pounds, the veteran campaigner, Tony Chiaverini.
And you can hear the Kansas City contingent. There's over 200 that have flown in for the fight.
Fighting out of New York City, New York, formerly of San Juan, Puerto Rico. He is the former welterweight champion of the world. He weighs 154.5 pounds. Here is Wilfred Benitez. 10 rounds of boxing.
Benitez losing that title in the 15th round to our colleague tonight, Sugar Ray Leonard, here in Las Vegas last November.
Okay, now I want a good, clean fight, guys. Watch your low blows, your holding and hitting. I'm going to let you work on the inside.
Right.
When I think you're tied up, I'm going to ask you to break, stop punching, and step back.
Yeah.
Now, if you lose your mouthpiece, keep boxing. In case of a knockdown, go to the furthest neutral corner and stay there until I ask you to come out. If you come out, the count will stop. Do you understand that?
Okay. Right.
Might cost you the fight now.
Right.
Okay? If you lose your mouthpiece, keep boxing. Shake hands with a good fight, fellas.
Yeah, the referee knows of what he speaks. Ferd Hernandez, former middleweight contender, the third man in the ring tonight. Benitez in the light blue trunks, and in the white with a blue trim is Tony Chiaverini. He's the Rocky of Kansas City. How they love him in Kansas City, Missouri. He's the left-hander, and you indicated, Ray, that the left-hander might cause Benitez some problems.
Yes, to a degree, Dick. What Chiaverini should be doing, you see he's doing that, he's bringing the fight to Benitez. Benitez seems to be very relaxed and just waiting for a good left hand.
Benitez is an excellent counter-puncher, is he not?
He's one of the best. I think he's one of the best counter-punchers out there today.
Look at this. Step back. Step back.
One of the indications to watch early was whether one man would take command of the fight in the early rounds. Both have the reputations of being slow starters, and the feeling is Chiaverini, and I know, Dr. Pacheco, it was your thought that Chiaverini had to go after him early if he was going to win this fight.
Chris, Angelo Dundee will make sure he comes after him. He sparred four rounds before he ever came out here. He's warmed up.
You see Dundee, veteran manager in the corner of Chiaverini. Chiaverini called Dundee after the loss to Leonard over a year ago, and since then, under Dundee's leadership, he has won five straight. And of course, Angelo's like a football coach. He'll build a fire under you. As Ray knows, you're going to hear from him. What's it like to fight under the watchful eye of Angelo?
It's like having three trainers in place of one. Angelo wants his fighter to fight each round and win each round big.
Good, solid left-right combination by Benitez. Chiaverini, the southpaw in the white trunks. Ooh, Benitez again, a solid hit. Benitez won the title, a world title, at the age of 17, the youngest ever to own a world championship. Welterweight champion at 20, then he lost at 21 to Sugar Ray Leonard. Chiaverini does get off Benitez, and you made the comment, Ray, after fighting Benitez, he couldn't believe how many times you missed him.
Well, yes, Benitez is such a superb counterpuncher, and one thing you have to see when you're watching this fight is the fact that Benitez will make you miss.
He's only 22 years of age, already twice a world champion. Benitez facing the camera, lost only once, and that's to Leonard. Chiaverini has been defeated but four times in over 40 bouts. So far, Chiaverini having difficulty landing anything. A short left hand scores. Closing seconds of round one. It'll be interesting to see how the fans at ringside score this first round. We'll show you that when we come back for round two. This middleweight's Tony Chiaverini in the white trunks against former champion Wilfred Benitez of Puerto Rico. Chiaverini, regarded as an awkward southpaw. There's the scoring of the ringsiders. 41% like Benitez. 35% saw that first round even. How'd you have it scored at home? Of course, that's totally unofficial. How about it? You fought Chiaverini. Is he difficult to find? You didn't seem to have any trouble with him.
Well, I think the lights and the cameras really got to Chiaverini. I'm quite surprised because Chiaverini did warm up in the back four rounds. He should be pretty loose, but then he seems so tight.
You're talking about tonight or against you?
Both times. Even here, he seems very tight. I think he's intimidated by his missing the punches of Benitez's head.
Dr. Pacheco?
He's very awkward. The first round, he's very, very tight. He kept popping his arms. But now this is the kind of fight he has to do. He has to drive him into the ropes and then maul and push. It's almost a miniature Duran Leonard fight.
Wife Debbie leading the cheers in the Chiaverini corner. Mother of two.
As long as he stays outside, he's going to get hit because Benitez is a superior boxer and he can pot shot him all night long. He has to rush him and push him into the ropes.
Midpoint round two, scheduled for 10.
One thing the viewers at home should watch out for is Benitez's straight right hand.
Break it. And he'll use that even as a counterpunch, will he not?
He will. Benitez also can convert into a southpaw position.
Benitez fighting about as heavy as he has ever been, 154 and a half. 147 for his defense against Leonard. Chiaverini actually up in weight since he fought Sugar Ray, more natural 155 and a half. Chiaverini pressuring Benitez inside, and indeed he is more effective when he crowds the slicker punching Benitez. Oh, good right hand underneath by the former welterweight champ Benitez.
He can't hesitate outside. He's got to rush in. Once he hesitates, he gets hit by a straight right. Benitez punching hard, Sugar.
He's carrying that weight now, Doc. He's put on a few pounds, and a lot of people think we'll slow him down. He's just as quick and just as effective with his punching ability.
I agree with you.
Angelo Dundee watching. You saw him in that insert as we come to the final seconds of round two. And a good flurry by Benitez. Round three here in Las Vegas. Tony Chiaverini, the southpaw and wide, against former champion Wilfred Benitez. Benitez, a solid right hand, and he follows with a left hook. And Chiaverini's in trouble. Ties him up and hangs on. Benitez landing cleanly with both the left hook and the right cross. Wife Debbie watching and at times closing her eyes.
I said earlier, Dick, that Benitez is very strong. They said he can't punch. I disagree. He punches very well.
And Chiaverini landed a good straight left hand.
Pause outside like he's doing. If he pauses there, he's going to get hit by everything Benitez throws. He can't hesitate. He's got to rush in like Duran did with Leonard. He must move in.
Again, not able to quite get off, Chiaverini. Indecisive. Thought he saw an opening, and then perhaps the defense of Benitez took it away. Or maybe in the back of the mind is that strong counterpunching of Benitez.
A guy like Benitez is considered a technician. And Chiaverini is not really sure of himself when he can land that punch.
Benitez back. We approach the midpoint of round three. It's a Chiaverini crowd. He's the underdog, and fans love to cheer from that point of view. And also a strong group of fans from Kansas City. But it's Benitez landing more solidly. Ooh, a vicious left hook after the right hand of the body set it up.
I can't remember Benitez punching this crisp and this hard before.
Did he fight this way against you? Of course, he had a different opponent that night.
Well, Benitez pretty much fought the same way. He wants to counterpunch, but when he felt that he could dominate, he would be the aggressor. But I don't think he hit him with the kind of blows that he's landed on Chiaverini.
Final minute, round three, and right hand winging by Benitez. Chiaverini trying to crowd him along the ropes.
It's interesting in scoring, the first round, Chiaverini blew the first round because he wasn't doing anything with his aggressiveness. He was aggressive, but wasn't doing anything. Now he's doing something with his aggressiveness. Chiaverini's landed a number of low blows.
With that left hand as he had it set up, and Benitez is able to pull back in time. But Chiaverini, obviously a much tougher opponent inside, as he has Benitez pinned against the ropes, end of round three. Jones, pleased that he joined us for the Friday night fights. Actually, he moves pretty well upstairs as well as downstairs, as you saw on the opening of our show, with Harry Wall and his son, the president of Caesars. Fine hospitality appreciated by all of us here at NBC. Don't forget, we'll be back with you next Friday night, and then 3 weeks from tonight with the Friday night fights. And next week, a battle of unbeatens. We'll be talking about that later. Round three, complete. And now into round four, a Chiaverini in the white trunks, Benitez in the light blue. Biggest payday for Chiaverini. He'll make $50,000, Benitez $70,000 for the action tonight.
Benitez just yelled.
Break! Break!
Break! He yelled, not the referee yelled.
Ooh, solid right hands by Benitez. One to the body and then to the jaw, and he follows with another.
Come on in, Johnny, get him!
See, Benitez, the big winner of round three in our ringsiders pool.
Break it! You paid him! Break it up! Break it!
How do you have the fight scored for the first three rounds, Doctor?
I hate to tell you, but it's even.
How about you, Ray?
I agree. Both fighters are exchanging dynamite blows. Chiaverini finished very strong the last round.
Chiaverini's not coming in, but he's not coming in punching, and he's getting hit coming in.
Wife Debbie? Chiaverini can use all the support he can against the heavily favored Benitez.
Well, he is doing very well against the heavily favored Benitez.
As he told us, he wants a title fight this year or he'll retire. He's done well. He has all of his faculties. He's an outstanding young man as a college graduate, and he wants to be a boxing champion, and he's looking for the chance with an impressive show tonight against Benitez, who lands a wicked left hook. Hurt, but continues to fight while wobbling.
Chiaverini's getting the worst of that exchange.
Both fighters, their faces reddened by constant attack here in round four.
At this pace, I'm curious to see what's going to happen in the next round. They both are landing dynamite body blows, and those body blows are going to take his toll in the next round. You'll see that.
Oh, right hand downstairs, and he doubled up, went upstairs, did Benitez.
And there's some blood on his nose of Chiaverini.
On the bridge of the nose, Benitez has delivered a cut to Chiaverini. It'll look worse than it really will measure, but it has to be an annoyance to Chiaverini. Chiaverini looks okay. They're clear.
He looks okay. He took a lot of shots, but I think his condition is paying off here.
He's very tough, Chiaverini.
Benitez landing 5-6 quick blows to one for Chiaverini.
Come on, Tony. Keep on looking.
Ferdy Pacheco at Caesars Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. And the crowd after that round four action and on its feet for the 10-15 seconds. Benitez regarded as the solid winner of the round by those voting at ringside.
They're right back where they left off, right above us.
So through the first four rounds, based on those casting their ballot to ringside, of course, this is totally unofficial. The crowd has Benitez solidly in front four rounds to none, but the official judges may not be seen that way, and in fact, our two expert commentators don't see it as a shutout this far.
Benitez is not going to hit by 1 point. And although Tony looks tired, he is not tired. He's in great shape. That's just the way he fights. He's like Gene Fulmer and those guys that look sloppy, but they just keep standing in front of you.
Benitez backed against the ropes. He beat Antonio Cervantes for the junior welterweight title in 1976 at the age of 17. No one has ever been a world champion at that tender an age. Won the welterweight championship in 79, defeating Carlos Palomino for the title.
If you watch the way that Benitez utilizes the ropes, he moves back, gets you off balance, and he throws combinations to build up points.
Ray, frankly, I don't understand Benitez staying on the ropes. Why would he want to fight Chiaverini's fight?
I feel he feels a lot stronger. He thinks he can outpunch Chiaverini. Both fighters are throwing body blows. I think Benitez's punches are more effective.
He'll spin a Chiaverini, and he landed the left hook, but partially picked off by Chiaverini. Fast combination by Benitez. Ooh, quick hand.
That sort of answered my question, Ray.
And he is more effective when he's off the ropes. Chiaverini seems to feel more confident when he's pressed body against body, where he can use his punches downstairs. Final minute, round five, as we approach the halfway mark of this 10-rounder. Angelo Dundee barking from Chiaverini's corner.
I think Benitez is definitely taking command now the last two rounds. He seems confident off the ropes, doesn't he, Ray?
He does. He always feels so relaxed, so confident in the ropes. He wanted me to go against the ropes the same way, but I stayed away.
And won the title.
Solidly, and he has Chiaverini in trouble, but the Kansas City kid comes right back. Oh, a wicked right hand by Benitez. NBC's Friday Night Fights will be right back after these messages from your local station. Five rounds in the book, round six scheduled for 10. No knockdowns. Tony Chiaverini, the southpaw and white from Kansas City, against Puerto Rico's Wilfred Benitez, backed against the ropes. And there's the former Brown Bomber, the great champion, Joe Louis. And it's good to see Joe healthy and back at ringside, enjoying the action here at Caesars tonight.
Benitez's mouthpiece just fell out. He really doesn't hold on to his mouthpiece that well. I guess he feels he really doesn't need it.
He's smiling too much all the time.
Benitez with 25 knockouts in his 38 victories, only one defeat to Leonard and one draw to Harold Weston. Chiaverini 36-4-1, he too losing to Ray Leonard. It's a good fight, good action fight, and after each round, the fans showing their total appreciation.
Benitez seems to be coasting now. He threw a lot of blows the last round. I think he's trying to regain his win.
Heavy winner in the eyes of the ringsiders. Round five was Benitez. Right above our microphone, let's listen to the action. Oh, a right hand by Benitez, and Chiaverini is hurt. Unprotecting himself, he took three straight right hands. Hook from Benitez. He fights back, but he's not protecting himself at all, is he?
No, he's not.
He's dazed and stunned.
Oh, almost tore his head off with that right hand.
Benitez is just taking his shots. He's just waiting to get a clear shot and let it fly.
He is showing good patience.
Benitez knows he's in control. He's just picking his shot, waiting for a good shot, but he's been landing some pretty good blows. the whole fight.
That's been a wrap on Benitez. If he doesn't finish, that he's got the guy in trouble, finish him off. But he doesn't do it. Content to rest and just wait.
Final minute, round six, and another big round for Wilfred Benitez. Chiaverini bleeding from that cut on the nose, also bleeding slightly from the mouth.
Chiaverini is totally confused now.
He's going for every fake.
Now, Benitez putting on a boxing show. These heavy punches have really taken a lot out of Chiaverini. He's not the same aggressive fighter that he was the first five rounds.
No, but it's ironic that he's the one that's coming forward to get all those heavy shots.
You can hide more, though. Hey, Rick.
Final seconds of round six. A big, big round for Benitez. Follow Tony Chiaverini to his corner. Angelo Dundee, Dave Controlla, his trainer, Ron Marsh, Gary Chiaverini, working feverishly. Let's listen to Angelo.
Son, don't go dropping your hands, Tom. Don't go dropping your fucking hands. Not blowing your nose. I know, and I told him the same thing. You got to defend yourself. You
now, Benitez landed heavily, both rights and lefts in round six. Let's go back and re-examine the action.
Well, here we see Benitez, knowing full well he's in complete control. He's switching to a southpaw position, and like I said earlier, Benitez is capable of fighting anyway. He's such a versatile fighter.
You know, it's easy to forget, Ray, that Benitez is still a baby in terms of age at 22. Just he's been around a long time and has fought as a champion. He's got plenty of years left.
I'm just 24, Dick.
Don't look at me, gang.
He's been looking at you too, Ray. Six rounds complete. Here's round seven. Chiaverini, the southpaw, against former champion Benitez.
And Chiaverini went right across the round and ring and right into Benitez.
Chiaverini was a middle linebacker in college. He's fighting at 155. He played at 185. Middle linebacker at Washburn University, Kansas. He's tough.
And he wishes he had his helmet on right now.
From our Luma lens, a unique device that allows you to go right inside the ring. Second time it's ever been used in a sporting event. Ted Nathanson, our producer-director, looking right into the eyes of Chiaverini. More to come next Friday. Undefeated, Dwight Davidson from Detroit, unbeaten, against Curtis Parker, Philadelphia. Two young undefeated middleweights. That'll be next Friday night at 10 Eastern Time here on NBC's Friday Night Fight. Right hand landing at will for Benitez.
Well, Benitez getting good leverage. If you watch his footwork, his stance, he really puts a lot of weight and body behind his blows.
A good defensive fighter. He's picked off a lot of the shots inside. Halfway through round seven. We have Muhammad Ali and Larry Holmes here next week scoring at ringside. It'll be interesting to see how they participate in ballots after each round. Ooh, good. Close inside by Chiaverini. And what does Chiaverini have to do at this point, Ray?
Well, in the sixth round, I thought he was hurt so bad they couldn't really defend himself. But he's doing the right thing now. He's going to the body. He's staying on top of Benitez.
Less than a minute remaining. Round seven.
Benitez is amazing in letting him stay on top of him in the corner and punch away for no reason.
Chiaverini should stay down to the body. It's very difficult to hit Benitez on his head.
Chiaverini picking off that right and left combination. Oh, beautiful. Doubled up on the jab and followed with a cross, and he repeats it.
The only defense Chiaverini's got is an offense. If he's not punching, he's dead.
Benitez scoring at will. Some thought he may not be in shape at 155, too heavy. Well, he's answered that rather emphatically. Seconds ticking away, the end of round seven. Welcome back, round eight. Wilfred Benitez, former welterweight champion, a very impressive show against Tony Chiaverini, a tough southpaw from Kansas City. He started well, but Benitez taking control of the fight in the fourth round and has been totally in command since. How do you have it scored?
Break it up, break.
I have it 69-63, Benitez, which means that Tony cannot win this fight unless he goes for a knockout. Of course, that's easier said than done.
Landed a good right hand. And the ringsiders have Benitez with a shutout, 7-love. Although some felt that Chiaverini might have won the one or two of the early rounds.
Benitez is ahead by a large margin. And like Dr. said, the only way Chiaverini can win is by knockout.
Oh, what a crisp left hook from Benitez. Wife Debbie Chiaverini trying to root on her husband. It has been a long Friday night for Chiaverini's, the entire clan. And as Benitez indicated, he's looking at Roberto Duran or anyone else that wants to offer him a big money fight.
What's interesting is, can Benitez come down to welterweight after fighting at 155 and still have all his punching power? That's going to be interesting to see.
He certainly has carried the weight well tonight. Maybe this is his division. In fact, when he won the junior welterweight title at 17, even then, his comments were, someday I'll be the middleweight champion. Maybe that is his way.
I think he's going in that direction. What a fine fighter he is. After eight rounds, you're left with the impression that he's far superior to Chiaverini, although Chiaverini's got scampy questions. He's in there fighting and banging.
If you notice, Benitez is trying to keep Chiaverini in the center of the ring. Chiaverini seems to be hurt now by his right hand by Benitez.
Less than a minute remaining in round eight. Solid left, right to the midsection of Chiaverini.
Those body shots really take it out of you, don't they, Ray?
They really do. I'm quite surprised. At this weight, Benitez is far more awesome than Chiaverini is.
You think he hits harder now as you watch him from ringside than he did against you?
Yes, he does. As a matter of fact, Benitez, he's young, and I think that weight now is becoming very normal, very natural.
Question now is also, will this be Chiaverini's last fight? If he is as solidly defeated in the final two rounds as he has been through the first eight, maybe it's time for him to say goodbye. He's indicated that.
I don't think so. He said so. He may not fight for the title. He's too good a fighter. After all, he is outclassed by one of the finest fighters in the world.
Two rounds to go. That's round eight. Don't forget, Sunday, a special edition of NBC Sports World Moscow. Once more, a review of the 1980 Olympic Games from opening to closing ceremonies, and a special look at that Battle of the Bretons, Ovet and Co. in the 1500 meters. That's all Sunday at 4 o'clock Eastern Time on NBC Sports World. Baseball tomorrow, the Cubs at San Francisco on NBC. Round 9, Wilfred Benitez, and that'll be it. Angelo Dundee has asked the fight to be stopped, and Wilfred Benitez, as Chiaverini does not answer, round 9 is the winner. Benitez celebrates the victory. Angelo Dundee mercifully ends the bout. He figured Chiaverini was taking much too much punishment. You see Benitez pointing to Chiaverini as if to say, hey, give this guy a hand. He was tough.
Well, Benitez won't get credit where it's due. A lot of the punches that Benitez hit Chiaverini with, the average guy would have went down.
So Benitez with his 39th victory. Wife Debbie, you wonder what's going through her mind. There's a man she loves. He's fought a tough fight, beaten thoroughly. Does she want him to continue? And does he himself? Here is the official announcement of the decision from ring announcer Chuck Hull.
They are not bad.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tony Chiaverini fails to answer the bell for the ninth round. The winner by a technical knockout in the eighth round, Wilfred Benitez.
So Benitez still has but one loss to mar a brilliant record, that 15-round defeat to Sugar Ray Leonard. And here's Dr. Pacheco.
Here we are. Well, Wilfred Benitez, the winner. Wilfred, you look very impressive.
Yes, I'm looking better than before. Now, for Chiaverini Leonard. Now, I'm trying to do a tremendous comeback. And I choose that I'm going to win my title. Hey, man. Hi. How are you?
Fine.
How you look the fight?
You look very strong.
You think that I'm strong to beat you, right?
You're very strong. I'm very impressed.
You know, I want Roberto Duran. Roberto Duran is afraid of me. I'm the dragon.
You're the dragon. And here's the dragon slayer.
Yes.
Listen, after you had him in trouble in the sixth round, why didn't you finish him off, Wilfredo? It took you an awful long time. He kept coming, coming.
They were looking for, there was like a trainee. You saw it. I was just a veteran boxer. I'm 21, and that's all. I'm the greatest.
But you kept fighting off the ropes. When you in the middle of the ring, you could have knocked him out. Did he hurt you at any time?
Yeah, he hurt me because the fight was a duel. You know, inside balls, he don't go so far. He was near me, so I hit him hard, and he hit me hard. So I
Ray.
You see the fight now. I'm the best.
They felt that the weight would slow you down, but it didn't. Seems to me you was much stronger and just as quick.
Right.
You feel the same.
Now you scare him, right? You're afraid of me now.
Let's give a brother Duran first.
Oh man. Let's see. Hey, listen. You supposed to fight me? You supposed to fight me the 23rd September. You will make the fight?
We will. After we get Duran first.
You're not gonna. But no. Yeah. Yeah. I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna be the world champion.
Wilfred, many people say you have a hard time getting down to 147. Will you have a difficult time to get it for 147 after 155?
Listen, if I train hard, if I have more dedicated in boxing, in training, I think I'm not gonna have no problem to become champion again.
All right, thank you very much, Wilfred. Good luck. You're one of the best fighters currently fighting.
Thank you very much.
Present company excluded. Thank you. And we have with us right now the gentleman that put up such a courageous and devastating battle, and Angelo Dundee. Angelo, it was your decision to stop the fight?
Oh, yes, definitely. Sure. He couldn't get nothing off. I hate to see a fighter have a night like he had tonight. Couldn't get his shots off. Couldn't nail the guy a good shot.
Still, you fought a very brave fight. Tony, did you feel like you had him when he went to the ropes and he fought your fight?
Well, no, I just, was trying to get my punches, my combinations together, trying to get a right hand and a left off and trying to catch him, and, I just couldn't.
You got caught with some of the most devastating shots. I don't think anybody could have held up to that. Did they hurt as bad as it looked like it hurt you?
Well, he hurt me, but, I was never going to go down or close to quitting.
Did you feel exhausted? Did you feel tired during the fight?
No, I'm in good shape. When you get hit that much, you got to feel tired. But, I wasn't, didn't think I'd get hit that much, and I did, and couldn't get nothing.
Well, the big question is now, you've said you're going to quit by 1980. I don't think you should. You're a great fighter. You got a lot of heart. Would you feel like you're going to quit by 1980?
Well, the way things go, you never know. I still think I got a shot coming one of these days. I'm going to get it, and when I do get it, I'm going to have a good fight. I had 7 in a row, and just didn't get it together. Wilfredo's a great fighter, and... I give it what I got, and I wanted to go a couple more, but...
You did as good as you could do. Angelo, how do you feel about it? Do you think he could keep on going, and do you think he can get a junior middleweight title fight?
Well, I think he deserves a shot. He was in there with a superior kid tonight.
Excuse me?
The guy had a great night.
Okay, and down...
Tell him, right, that I beat Duran, right? He's afraid of me, right? You know that he's afraid of me.
We got
a dragon. You are right.
Oh, he's a dragon.
All right. Now we got to go back down to Dick Enberg before I get killed here between Angelo and the champion. Wilfred.